In the previous lessons, you've learned in fine detail how you can run a three-phase motor with a star-delta starter. Then you also learned how to configure the necessary PLC modules in the software environment based on the PLC modules that you have on the rack in the actual environment. In part 9 of this video series, you're going to learn how to define the exact address for each device that you have in your system, so that you can use those addresses in your PLC program. To get started writing the PLC program, the first thing that I always need to know is, what are the inputs and the outputs of the system or the machine that I'm trying to control using a PLC program? Based on the diagram that I have here, I can say that I have two inputs and three outputs for this system. The inputs include the start and the stop switches, and the outputs include the main, the star, and the delta contactors. If I take a look at the input module's details in the hardware, this DI32 tells me that this module has 32 digital inputs. This means that I'm able to connect 32 different digital signals from 32 different devices to this module. In the I address section, it says that the addresses for this module start at byte 0 and continue all the way to byte 3. So, the total number of memory bytes that are available for addressing this module is 4 bytes. Given the fact that every byte includes 8 bits, I can say that I have 32 bits of memory space that I can use for addressing this module. So now, I know that the DI module that I have installed on the rack has 32 inputs. Now, what are the addresses for each input? Since the input addresses start at byte 0, the address for the first input of this module would be IOO. Using that same model, the next input address for this module would be IO1, and the next one would be IO2. This continues all the way up to the last input address, which is I37. Here, the letter I shows that this address belongs to the inputs. The first digit represents the byte number, and the second digit represents the bit number. For example, here, IO2 is the input number 2, or the bit number 2, from byte number 0. As I mentioned before, I have two inputs for this system, and if I want to write a PLC program and use these inputs in my program, I have to know the exact address for each of these switches. Now, assuming the start switch is connected to the first input of the digital input module, the address that I can use for this switch in the program is IOO. And assuming the stop switch is connected to the next input of the same module, its address would be IO1. For the output module, DO16 tells me that this module has 16 digital outputs. And again, this tells me that I'm able to connect 16 different devices that are capable of receiving digital signals to this module. In the queue address section, I see that the addresses for this module start at byte 4 and continue to byte 5. This is 2 bytes, or 16 bits. Considering these addresses, I can say that the first output's address for this module is Q40. The next is Q41, and this continues all the way to the last output address, which is Q57. If the main contactor is connected to the first output of the digital output module, the address that I can use for this output in the software is Q40. With the same assumption, the address for the star and the delta contactors that are connected to the second and third outputs are Q41 and Q42, respectively. Now I know all of the addresses for each device that I have in the system. Now, here's what I want from you in the comments below this video. What have you learned from watching this video? Can you imagine implementing something from this video in your next PLC programming project? A great motivator for us to produce free, valuable content for you is the audience's acknowledgement that they found this video useful. If that describes you, please hit the like button. That will also help others to more easily find our videos on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't already done so. When you subscribe, each new video will be sent to you as quickly as it's published. Thank you so much for watching. RealParse has a large, continually growing library of practical programming lessons. Visit realparse.com, where you can sign up for a free 1-month trial. In your trial, you'll have instant access to our entire library, as well as the new videos that are produced weekly. With these videos, you'll advance your programming skills using step-by-step, easy-to-follow practical programming examples. You'll also have access to the questions and comments arena, where you're encouraged to ask questions, make suggestions, collaborate with peers, write about your experiences, and have the opportunity to network with people that are interested in the same professional field that you are. You may cancel your subscription at any time. To learn more, head on over to realparse.com now, where your free trial awaits. You're just a few short clicks away from learning valuable skills and starting your path to a new career.